Good afternoon. You're watching Proactive London. Charlie Gordon, Head of Investor Relations, joins us from Hochschild Mining. Because, Charlie, your interim results are out in the last couple of days, so we're going to be unpacking those and just having an overview of what you're doing at Hochschild. First of all, good to see you. Thanks for your time. Tell us how things are progressing with you at the moment.
Thanks, Chris. We announced our interim results last week. And I think generally the market saw that they were in line with expectations. We had revenue sort of around about 350 million. EBITDA was 131. We paid out a dividend of $10 million. And our cash balance at the moment is just over 200 million. So we feel we're in pretty good shape. Our operations, which are, as you may know, in Peru and in Argentina, produced in the first half just shy of 170,000 gold equivalent ounces. That's taking the silver ounces and converting them into one number, into the gold ounces. And we're on track for our production target of 360 to 375,000 ounces for the year. The costs, which can be compared with the gold price, were $1,371 an ounce. And our target is between 1330 and 1370. So very much on track with all our targets, which I think, Chris, we're quite proud of, because in an environment of a lot of inflation around in the industry, we've proved we've been able to keep a lid on inflation across the group. The other thing we really talked about in the interims was that our Mara Rosa project, which is a project we've just started building in Brazil. And it came with it from an acquisition called Amarillo Gold, which we completed in April this year. Last week or 2 weeks ago, we received final construction permit. And so we're sort of starting with all guns blazing there. And we're also advancing our other projects, SNIP, which is a project in British Columbia and Canada. And also we've delivered some decent drill results at one of our other mines, Palancat in Peru.
I say you mentioned Peru and Argentina, but Mara Rosa as well in Brazil. That's advancing on schedule then. And also I noticed you had a key environmental authorization announced earlier in the month of August, in this month. That must have been very important to you.
That was the key permit we were waiting for in Brazil. It allows us to clear the site for constructing the plant. And, you know, as you know, with permits, it's not an area one wants to predict down to the sort of week and month. But, you know, the project remains on track to produce its first gold in the first half of 2024. You know, the capital expenditure for the project remains at $200 million.
And you mentioned, I know obviously from your background, you've got a 50-year standing in mining out there in South America. But you mentioned about the permit. So the relationship with the local authorities must be very important to you. And you're cultivating those all the time, I would imagine.
That's been very important for us over those 50 years, increasingly in the last few years in Brazil. As I said, we finished that purchase on the 1st of April and have had a really, really warm welcome from the local community in the Goiás state. Whether it be the local governments, the local people who are already working on the project. We received a great welcome. The social license to operate for us is very important. And in Peru, obviously, we've got some very long-term relationships that we have with local communities. And in Argentina, slightly less so, that there are less local communities. But it's very important to us to also to employ local people. So, it's been gratifying in Brazil and the same actually in Canada as well. And, you know, that was a project that we brought into the portfolio in October last year. So, absolutely crucial to be able to operate a mine going forward.
I will ask, obviously, the local relationship is very important to you, and people may not think you've been overtly affected being in South America, but what's the current geopolitical situation doing for you with Russia and Ukraine? Has that affected operations at all, or are you seeing any kind of different impact on the business, even from that far away?
Well, I mentioned inflation, but obviously the other absolutely very, very important is our underlying commodities, gold and silver. When the invasion started in, I think, the end of February, gold and silver rose a lot. They've come back quite a bit. And to be fair, have just been rather volatile. So they have impacted that. And of course, as well as that, a number of key inputs we have, such as diesel or oil, and of course, inflation I mentioned, you know, with labor. So those sort of have started to pick up. And we've, as I said at the beginning, we've managed to keep a lid for the time being on that. And but no, we haven't escaped that impact. And of course, the economic impact is beginning to be apparent in the countries we operate in, Peru, in Argentina. Argentina's inflation rate at the moment, I believe, is officially around 60%. So a tough environment to operate in. The good thing is that the mine we have in Argentina called San Jose is extremely high grade, so can withstand a lot of inflation. But no, these countries have not been untouched by what's been going on. And then before that, obviously, the effects of the pandemic.
Absolutely. Despite that, you say you're on track, you're making good progress, and you're feeling good about the results so far. What's the outlook then for Hochschild for the next quarters? Do you believe you're on track to deliver on your projected targets?
Absolutely. Production and costs, we've got a proud record actually of meeting our guidance every year for the last 10 or so years. And then we really have four key targets for the company in the next quarter, but also over the next year or two. And that is optimizing our Immaculata mine in Peru. That's our flagship gold silver operation in southern Peru. As I mentioned before, constructing the Mara Rosa project, first production in 2 years. We're trying to get to feasibility in our SNIP project in Canada. And by the end of this year, we should have a pre-feasibility study ready. So that'll be something to look out for. And as well as that, we're always on the lookout for adding further projects to the pipeline, probably in the Americas. That's really our you know, where we look. So whether it be M&A or greenfield projects, you can hope to see a little bit more developments on that front.
Well, it sounds like you've got a truly global outreach there, Charlie, and plenty to keep you occupied for the second half of the year. Hopefully you'll come back and give us some updates as and when you get them.
I very much look forward to that, Chris.
Thanks very much. That's Charlie Gordon, Head of Investor Relations at Hochschild Mining on Proactive London today.